special teams, we see so many of these violent cases, right? And I can't help but to always go back to when you were called back to me and you gave us the thumbs up. And we see that it's kind of the uniform message that players do when we see that situation. And every time I see it, I cringe. And every time I see it, I think of that day. And, you know, here you are today being honored with a prestigious award, but watching the game today, it sounds like you have no regrets listening to the speak. And I think a lot of people want to get your perspective, especially when there's so much criticism of the game of football out there.
You know, I appreciate you bringing that up. And the reason why I like this kind of discussion is that I would do it all over again. I love the game. My parents made sure I understood that the game of football, or any sport, is a privilege. It was your responsibility to get out there and volunteer at the compound, the rectory, or your next door neighbors to help them out. And that's what my parents did. So every time I had the opportunity to cross that white line, I gave 100%. My first year in the NFL, when I shot my right leg, I was carried off. I tried to get up and walk off the field. Because a man walks on and he walks off. That's the responsibility of the NFL. You don't lay down and jump up and jog off. You know, you get up and you get off. And you
know.
But I couldn't. And so I was carried off. And my good man, I promised myself that I would never be carried off again. In 1991, November 17th, when I was carried off the field, I broke a promise to myself. And that bothers me more, that promise breaking, than the actual injury itself. Why? I brought it out of the game by doing my responsibility. And in that moment, I failed. And so, in retrospect, I'm going to make sure I do everything I can to honor the game of football that should have shown.
But you say you failed. Did you personally fail, or was it more of a physical thing that nobody would have overcame? I think you're being very hard on yourself.
You know, I appreciate that, but it's the way I look at it. And it drives me when I'm in the weight room or I'm doing the physical therapy or competing with the wife. It's the respect I want to give back. What my parents taught me to be a role model, to be a man, to be a household. And that's not pushing somebody out, not making a decision. Somebody has to do it, and it's going to be me.
All right, College Football Hall of Famer Mike Utley here, really spreading a good message. And, you know, let's talk about your career. Let's look back at, you know, your collegiate career a little bit. You're here with all this greatness around you. I mean, what comes to mind on the gridiron when you look back at your life?
I tell you, there's some of them fellas up there still pretty swollen, so these fellas can play. It's, you know what it is? It's a little rubbing some rock salt and some issues, you know. You have, you know, these are watching these guys and being a national champion and these kind of things. And God, that's phenomenal. And I'm humbled by the ability to be here and working with these, seeing these men up there, and especially my coaches. And they gave up themselves. Yes, some of them they led. Yes, sometimes part of saying yes for a coach, I guess, is called herding cats. And I was one of them cats, and I just have to.
And, you know, I heard you talking in the previous interview. Still welcome back always to Lions organization. I know you get out to some games, but you're watching games at all levels now, where you say, from the Pee Wee all the way up to the
end. Absolutely. It's watching what the Youth Foundation does for the, you know, the Pee Wee sports. And remember, the NFL's involved with that because that's their future. And look what's going on in society. It's the children, it's this country's future. By teaching them, in my opinion, to play the greatest game ever, football, but teach them to be accountable for their actions on and off the field, and it's just an opportunity to pay it forward and watch these kids grow, because, you know, like I said, America's the greatest place in the world, and football is a part of America.
And we saw all those great leaders go back to their high school days and youth football days and their coaches installing leadership. And since we are talking youth football and we have dabbled in violence in football. There's a lot of talk now that maybe contact football shouldn't really begin until middle school or even high school. How do you think that would work with football development moving forward? Is that a recommendation you would encourage or not?
The answer is, let the kids play. I started when I was 7 years old. And let the kids play this great game. And again, when that happens, by God, make them volunteer outside of this great game of football.
Well, Mike, I think...
That was an interview with Mike Utley. Great message for all the athletes out there. We're going to go to the Danny Werfel Trophy presentation coming up soon.